All right, here's something that a friend of mine I used to work with at the Car Quest before we closed. He does scrap, and he found this sitting out for the garbage, and it's a Midland AM/FM stereo cassette boombox, a two-way four-speaker. And conveniently, we have frequency and impedance graphs here. This is made in Korea.
Okay.
It's a model 19-111, Midland International, Kansas City, Missouri. So this was a Western Auto product, and it has a beat switch or FM stereo or mono. The plug on the back, which I had to go find a plug at the Goodwill, because he said the thing was full of corroded batteries, as we can see. Somebody left the batteries in there and they corroded. Maybe it'll be cleaned up, but I haven't gone that far because I haven't tested the unit out. You can see how dirty it is. Nothing on the sides. Some discoloration. Oh, we got a knob missing. Actually, the volume knob was missing. I just switched it over from the tone control. Headphone jack. Typical stuff. So it's plugged in. Let's see what it does. Nothing. Let's see if I still got it plugged in.
Salud y servicios.
Plugged in the fit very well.
He's your dog.
He's your dog. Looks like the dial string broke.
13 años. Protege el futuro de tu hijo en cada etapa de su vida. Visita safercar.gov/protegidos.
Un mensaje del National Highway Traffic Safety Administration y el Ad Council.
Sticker down there. I can hear the motor running, but I guess the belt's going. Nothing's happening there. Well, I guess let's open her up and take a look. So let's have a look at the two-way four speakers. There's the top speakers, as you can see. Some kind of little aluminum knockout plate there. Yep, I guess that's a speaker.
Well,
you know what?
No.
That must be some type of little tweeter, because they do have wires going soldered to the back of them. How about that? Well, we can see the corrosion down there. Here we get a good view of the tape mechanism. There's all the screws falling out the back. So, looks like pretty standard fare, early mid 1980s stuff. Looks like the speakers just set in here, as you can see. Like they're held, is that held magnetically? No, that's rubber. Okay. So the speakers just fit into these things. That's a little unusual. Of course, it makes servicing easier. Here's our Mitsumi DC motor for the cassette drive. Now what we have to figure out is, looking through here, and the dial string's not broken. In fact, it looks like the spindle in here may have cracked. No, the spindle's spinning. So the dial string is just slipping. Well, I can't do this one-handed. I'm going to work it back and forth and see what's going on. Okay, I don't know how right this is. The string's intact, but it's very slack. It's very loose. So I'm going to take a look at this, and I see it actually fell off of this back here. It's supposed to come back over to where this piece of plastic is broken, so that's our problem. This post, you can see, this post is broken, so there's nothing to put any tension on the dial string anymore. The hell you do about that? Let's see. Well, I guess for now this is kind of a lost cause, because where you see... Boy, is this going to come out? Okay, where you see that little... Where you see this little thing right here, that was a plastic post that the dial string wrapped around nice and snug so you could tune. And I actually stuck a screwdriver in here and hooked it, and the thing still tunes, and the darn thing all still works, but I mean, what the heck do you do about that? And it looks like I unscrewed this, but it looks like that post actually went through to something, went through the circuit board somehow. So then the AM works. It's very quiet between stations, not very sensitive. Don't know, do we see an antenna in here? Oh, there's our ferrite bar antenna way back in the corner there. What the hell do you do? No point in really going any further with it. You know, if it would have been an easy fix for the dial string, I'd have just, you know, wiped it down, because it's pretty filthy, but I'd have wiped it down and used it as a work radio, you know? I already have one of those. It's not in great cosmetic shape, but still functions perfect. This one wouldn't have been bad. It don't really sound bad. The FM tuner has a lot of bleed over and from some of the stronger stations in some sections, but I was able to tune in all the main stations, you know. The cassette deck, you know, probably just needs the belt, I'm sure. You know, everything else would have been serviceable. But, you know, cheap Korean construction on this plastic's age. Well, there we go. I guess this one's going to go in the junk pile. Maybe something out of here can be reused in something else one day. At least the speakers are okay. It's a shame, but oh well. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. At least I got a good aerial for something else. Alright.